Welcome to Rainforest Cafe at Downtown Disney. My name is David. Here with me, I have Blake, our greenling macaw. Blake, can you say hi?
Hi.
Good boy. Blake is one of four parrots that stay with us here at Rainforest Cafe. We have three macaws. Each one is a different species. We also have one Malandan cockatoo. Blake is our youngest bird. He is only 8 years old. I know that may sound a little old to be our youngest bird, but these birds have an average life expectancy of 60 to 80 years, so he is still fairly young, even at 8 years old. You trying to wings? Good boy. You'll notice when Blake does something good, he gets a treat. Right there, he got a pine nut. He also gets walnuts and sunflower seeds for his training treats, but his main diet consists mostly of fresh fruits and vegetables. He gets a wide variety first thing every morning. Blake also gets a pellet diet each day, which is sort of like an omnivore, but for birds. It's specially formulated for large parrots, and it meets all of his nutritional needs. His training treats, the seeds and nuts are a little bit high in fat, although they are healthy types of fats. We limit them to special treats for training and good behavior, so that Blake keeps a healthy and balanced diet. Blake, you like this? Good boy, can you laugh?
Good boy.
Greenling macaws come from the rainforest of Central and South America, and they have several adaptations to help them live safely and comfortably in the wild. If you look at Blake's foot, you'll see that he has two toes in the front of his foot and two toes in the back. That's an adaptation called zygodactyl. If you get a chance to look at some of the native birds around here, if you look at them real closely, you might see that they only have one toe in the back, but three in the front. Blake's zygodactyl foot, with two toes in the front and two toes in the back, gives him a much stronger grip than other birds. I'll see if I can have Blake demonstrate just how powerful his grip really is. Blake, what's up back to?
Good boy.
You can see I'm not holding onto him at all. He's able to support all of his body weight while hanging upside down. He can even eat while he's doing that. That's something that Blake might do if you're living in the wild and he wanted to pick some fruit that was growing in a really hard-to-reach place. He can hang upside down from the branches and stretch his neck out real far. That would allow him to easily pick that fruit from the tree. Blake, can you get a rooster?
Good boy.
If you look inside of Blake's mouth, you might get a chance to see another one of his adaptations. If you look at Blake's tongue, you'll see that it's very dark. It's almost jet black. That's to help protect him from the intense sunlight that he received, but he's so high up in the trees in the rainforest canopy. Blake does have another adaptation in his tongue which you cannot see, but believe it or not, he actually has a bone that goes right through the middle of his tongue. That bone makes Blake's tongue very rigid and powerful. That allows him to use it as a tool to help him remove these seeds and nuts from their shells once he cracks them open with his powerful beak. Blake, what's your favorite meat?
Good boy.
It's estimated that Blake has about 2,000 pounds per square inch of force in his bite. To give you an idea of how strong that is, he could easily break through a broomstick in one bite if he wanted to. But he can be very gentle at the same time. I'll see if I can have Blake demonstrate just how powerful his beak is, yet how gentle he can be at the same time. You can see I am not holding on to him at all. He's able to support all of his body weight while hanging by his beak. But at the same time, he's gentle enough that he literally just on my finger without pinching me or hurting me in any way. Say hello. There are 17 different species of macaws. Two of those are extinct in the wild, and there are three that are on the endangered species list. While the greenling macaw is not an endangered species, their numbers are declining in the wild, and they do face the same threats as those other birds. The biggest threat that they face in the wild is deforestation, from people cutting down the large trees they live in to make room for grazing cattle and to make products from those trees. Like, what do you say to people that want to cut down the rainforest? Good boy. I'll have Blake step up here and demonstrate something that he likes to do to show us what all of us can do to help do our part to slow down deforestation, help save the rainforest, and protect these amazing animals. You catch? boy. He's been. Did you show everybody how to recycle? Good boy. High five. That's Blake recycling. It's very easy. If Blake can do it, then of course all of us can do it. That's something that all of us can do to help do our part to save the rainforests. Now, if there's anyone out in the audience that might have their picture taken with Blake, he does love to meet new friends and post for pictures. The only thing I ask is that you please don't touch him. He does have a very powerful beak, and he can become a little bit nervous at times. But if you'd like to have your picture taken with him, don't be shy. Get him up to the stage, and we'll come out and pose with everyone.